Hello everyone. In this video, let's learn how to evaluate Levy Jennings chart for WestGuard rule violations and associated errors. But before this, you should first watch previous three videos on laboratory quality control. Link is given in the description box. We know that quality control in a clinical laboratory is a statistical process designed to ensure accurate and precise results of the investigations performed in the laboratory. Quality control is of two types, internal quality control and external quality control. Internal quality control is done by using quality control material and cross-checking the results with the values known to us by using Levy-Jennings chart and WestGuard rules, and this is done on the daily basis. Levy-Jennings chart is a graphical method for displaying control results and evaluating whether a run is in control or out of control. Mean and standard deviations are required to construct this LJ chart, and daily the values are plotted versus time. These WestGuard rules decide whether an analytical run is in control or out of control, and these WestGuard rules can be applied only if quality control values are plotted within the range of mean plus minus 3 standard deviation. There are various WestGuard rules like 1:2S, 2:2S, 1:3S, 4:1S, 10X, R:4S. Let's understand the nomenclature with the help of 1:2S. 1 represents N, that is number of control measurements, and 2S represents L, that is limit exceeded, which can be plus minus 1, 2 or 3 standard deviation. 1:2S, 2:2S, 1:3S, 4:1S and 10X rule violation denote systematic error. 1:2S, 1:3S, R:4S rule violation denote random error. Systematic error is representative of inaccuracy and random error represents imprecision. Now let's understand each rule in brief and begin with the 1:2S rule. This is a Levy-Jennings chart which is created with the help of mean plus minus 1, 2 and 3 standard deviation. Here you can see that control values are plotted here. In the fifth run, you can see that this control measurement is above 2 standard deviation. It means that it is violating 1:2S rule. One control measurement above plus minus 2 standard deviation is 1:2S rule, which denotes random error or the beginning of systematic error. What is 2:2S rule? When one level of control is used in this condition, if two control measurements are above plus or minus 2 standard deviation limits on the same side of mean in same level of control on two consecutive runs, then it is 2:2S rule. For example, here you can see that in the fourth run, the control measurement is above 2 standard deviation, and also in the fifth run, the measurement is above 2 standard deviation. So this violates 2:2S rule. When two levels of control are used, for example, yellow denotes level 1 and blue denotes level 2 of control. In this condition, if two control measurements are above plus or minus 2 standard deviation limits on the same side of mean in different level of control in the same run, then it violates 2:2S rule. For example, in the level 1, the control measurement is above 2 standard deviation, and in the level 2 also, the control measurement is above 2 standard deviation in the same analytical run. This means that it violates 2:2S rule. In 1:3S rule, one control measurement exceeds 3 standard deviation. It is random error or a beginning of large systematic error. 1:3S is a rejection rule. 4:1S rule is applicable for one level and two level controls. If only one level of control is used, then four consecutive control measurement, if they exceed one standard deviation on one side of mean, for example, here you can see this second, third, fourth and fifth control measurement exceeding one standard deviation, it is called as 4:1S rule. When two levels of control are used, then two consecutive control measurements exceeding one standard deviation in both level of control. For example, in the level 1, two values exceeding one standard deviation, and in the second level of control also two values, consecutive values exceeding one standard deviation, it becomes 4-1-S rule, and it is a rejection rule which denotes a systematic error. R4S rule is applicable when two levels of control are used. In this condition, there is 4 standard deviation difference between two data points. For example, in level 1, this yellow represents level 1, I get a data on the second run, I get data point here, and in the level 2 control, I get data point here, and there is difference of 4 standard deviation between data points of both the levels, then it is R4S rule. It denotes a random error and it is a rejection rule. In 10X rule, if one level of control is used, in that condition, if 10 consecutive control measurements are on the one side of mean in one level of control in 10 consecutive runs. For example, you can see here that 10 consecutive runs, the values are on the one side of mean, and that's why it is violating 10X rule. When we are using two levels of control, in that condition, 5 consecutive control measurements are on one side of the mean in two levels of control in 5 consecutive runs. For example, in level 1, if you are getting 5 consecutive control measurement on one side of mean, and in the level 2 control also you are getting 5 consecutive measurements on one side of mean, then it is violating 10X rule and it is a rejection rule. It denotes systematic errors. Let's see when to accept or reject the run. Observe the control data. If 1-2S rule is not violated, then run is in control. Accept that run. If it is violated, it is just a warning rule. Do not reject the run, but look for other errors. If 1-3S rule is also not violated, and 2-2S rule, R4S rule, 4-1S rule, and 10X rule, all the rules are not violated, then we have to accept the rule because our run is in control. But if 1-3S rule is violated, then it is out of control. We have to reject the run, look for the errors, troubleshoot, and take corrective measures. 2-2S is also a rejection rule. R4S, 4-1S, and 10X. All these are the rejection rule. We have to reject the run if all these rules are violated. Let's evaluate the Levigening chart. The question is, study the Levigening chart, identify control rules violated, mention the type of error most likely associated with the control rule violation. In this Levigening chart 1, are you able to see any control rule violation? Take a few moments and think about it. Keep in mind all the rules. So at this position, this control measurement is above the 3 standard deviation. So when one measurement is above 3 standard deviation, it violates which rule? 1-3S rule, and it denotes a random error or a beginning of large systematic error. In this second Levigening chart, observe all the control measurements and you will see that at 12th run, this control point is above this minus 2 standard deviation. So this is 1-2S rule. This is a warning rule. This is not a rejection rule. It denotes a random error or the beginning of systematic error. In this LJ chart, you can see from the third run, all measurements are on the one side of mean. If you calculate, these are 10 values. So this denotes which rule? 10X rule. Because 10 consecutive control values are on one side of mean, this is 10X rule violation, which shows systematic error. Observe this LJ chart carefully. Two levels of control material are used and values, control measurement values are plotted. From the 8th run, you can see all the control values are on one side of mean. And there are 10 control measurements. So it is violating 10X rule because 5 consecutive control values on one side of mean in 2 levels of control material. This is 10x rule violation, which shows systematic error. In this LJ chart, you can see that 11th and 12th run, both the values are above minus 2 standard deviation. So when two values are exceeding 2 standard deviation, which rule is this? This is 2-2S rule, because two consecutive control measurements exceeding minus 2 standard deviation here in this case. It denotes a systematic error. This is a LJ chart for two levels of control. Actually, in reality, we don't use the same LJ chart for both level of control. We use different charts, but for the sake of interpreting, it is given together. In this chart, you can observe that all the values are not violating any rule, but here on the 12th run, you can see for level 1 control, this value is exceeding 3 standard deviation. So it means that it is violating 1-3S rule, and it denotes a random error or the beginning of large systematic error. This chart also for two levels of control, observe all the control values, and this run, 12th run, shows there is 4 standard deviation difference, 1, 2, 3, 4 SD difference between values of two levels of control. This is level 1 and this is level 2 control. So which rule is this? When 4 standard deviation difference between the control measurements of two levels, it is R4S rule. Because there is 4 SD difference between two control measurements in two levels of control, and it denotes a random error. In this LJ chart, it is for two levels of control. If you observe this, there is no rule violation and there is no error in this LJ chart. In this LJ chart number 8, only one level of control is used, and if you take a look at all the control measurements, there is no rule violation is seen. So you should write no rule violation and no error.